grieve not on our side. Had been the Lord of hosts, let we all now proclaim. When against odds arose, evil foe, thanks we give unto God, our merciful Father. Loud hosanna to his name. We give thanks to Jehovah, who from evil snares saved us. Thanks be to thee, O God. We call down evil strength.
Are you hearing what I'm saying? This is BGM 181 MP blocking somebody's entrance. Please go and repack. And another one, this one has no identity. Now the ring number has no, what is this? R-what? This is a golf vehicle. Toyota R4, RGM 246HM. You are blocking somebody, other tenants. Please go and remove your vehicles, or else we will ask the people to open their garage and drag your vehicle inside. Please go and repack. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I'm delighted to be here today. That's the truth. I'm delighted. I like what I have seen. And the same God who helped you to start it will give you all it takes to complete it. Your amen has problem. And as you complete this, you will complete your own. Praise the Lord. I'd like to appreciate my fathers in the Lord who have permitted me to share a few words with us today. Let's turn our Bibles to Isaiah chapter number 65. I think that's where we had our first lesson today. How many of you were here when you read the first lesson? And where did we read from? 60 what? Is your only 66? Okay. We read from 65 and we'll connect there. Praise the Lord. 65 says, I am sought of them that ask not for me. I am found of them that sought me not. I said, behold me unto a nation that was not called by my name. I have spread out my hands all the day unto a rebellious people which walked in a way that was not good after their own thoughts. A people that provoked me to anger continually to my face. I read the New Living Translation. It says, I was ready to respond, but no one asked for help. I was ready to be found, but no one was looking for me. I said, here am I to a nation that did not call on my name. All day long I opened my arms to a rebellious people, but they followed their own evil paths and their own crooked great schemes. All day long they insult me to my face by worshipping idols in their sacred gardens. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. To speak to us today on that word, behold me, behold me, behold me, behold me. That's God's word. Say, look at me, look at me, look at me. Hello? God is saying, look at me. There is recession all over the land. Look at me. There is anger all over the place. Look at me. There is all malice, there is problem all over the land. Look at me. You have no job. Look at me. You are looking for a child.
Choice. You either follow God or you follow the world.
You either follow the Almighty God or you follow man. You either follow one, the one who is the creator of heaven and earth, or you follow that your uncle whom you have put your trust and confidence in. And he said, vain is the help of man. Costly he that put his trust in man and not in the living God. Everyone that trusts in the Lord this year, the theme of our church this year will come upon you. Somebody answer me. She is not a scientist. She wasn't a scientist. She didn't study oceanography. She doesn't know anything about marine studies. But she put a basket on top of the river, put her son inside that basket, and the basket did not sink. So the basket moved to where they want the basket to go to. The basket did not go into the open field. he said, listen, I love you too much. I have loved you with an everlasting love. Don't bother about who doesn't like your face. Don't bother about who hates you and despises you. They hated Joseph. That did not stop him from getting to the palace. They hated David. That did not stop him from becoming a king. They hated others. He didn't stop them. He can't stop you. He can't stop you. Their hatred can't stop you. And he couldn't see his moment of victory, his moment of breakthrough, his moment of deliverance. And he was still saying, I have nobody. Who told you you need man when Jesus is around? Who told you you need man when God is with you? Who told you you need man when the Almighty has spoken concerning you? Who told you? Who told you? Who told you? Somebody said, I don't have long legs. My father, I don't know about you. My father sits in the heavens and makes the earth his footstool. So I don't know the height of heaven, how far off it is. Are you hearing me? And if you are being in an aircraft and you travel abroad, they go at higher heights than the local heights. Even from that height, you will not be able to see an aircraft. They look tiny on the ground. The biggest building looks tiny, and I can imagine. My papa was sitting in heaven, and the leg as long as that. And all I have to do, if my legs are short, is to switch legs. I just plant his legs, and wherever his leg enter, can anybody deny you? Hallelujah. In Matthew 11:28, say, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. I will give you rest. He has stretched out his hand towards you. He is waiting for you to come to him. That's who he is. That's what he has been doing. He is a helper. He makes it possible to be possible. He looked at the 90-year-old woman and said, I will make you a mother. And he made her a mother. Never has it ever occurred that a 90-year-old woman would become a mother. It has never happened before. That is God. As far as it's concerned, impossibility is not his entire. I don't know about you, but he said, choose you this day whom you will serve, the gods of your fathers or the Most High God. But as for me and my house, we will serve the living God. Praise the Lord. And in from verse 13 of that Isaiah 65, he began to talk about what his people will go through and those who despise him, what they will go through. So my people will eat, but they will be hungry. My people will be clothed, but they will be naked. My people will have to drink, but those ones will be tasty. He began to enumerate. And from verse 17, he began to talk about new heavens and a new earth. And he said, listen, you will not toil in vain. You will not labor in vain. You will build houses and inhabit them. You will plant vineyards and preach. You start having problems, you go back. I said, Baba, you didn't tell me, you said you didn't ask. Hello? Hello? We have a God who loves us so much. Very compassionate, very loving. We are anointed too much. Oh, yeah, I'm right. Hallelujah. I said, Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said, Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, brethren in the Lord, decide now how you want to live your life, how you want to make it this year, what you want to do with your life this year. Rather on the side of God, on the side of the world. Rather trust in the Lord Almighty, who will put your trust in man, and that man will feed you. Abraham said, I will not take anything from you, lest you go and boast that you are one woman in the rich. That is somebody who has absolute trust in the Lord Almighty. Behold me. Behold me. Whatever it is you are seeking for, say, look at me. You need a job? Look at me. You need a wife? Look at me. You need breakthrough? Look at me. Whatever it is, I am available to supply them to you. So, brethren in the Lord, it is an insult to the Almighty God that you put your trust in man. It is an insult to God Almighty that people still go to shrines, to oracles, to go and ask for things, to go and seek for help. It is an insult to the Almighty God that you go and say, I am not going to go and follow them to worship, but I will send my money. Whether you send your money or you send your leg here. Behold, the hour of the canal is when the two worshippers worship God in truth and in spirit. Because the Father seeketh such. Are you a true worshipper? Are you one of those who have made up their mind to serve this God in truth and in spirit? Let me also tell you, anything can happen to anybody any moment. And if you die in sin, that's to be too much. His love is too much. His love is everlasting. But he can't force you. You have to make up your mind to accept all that. That is all that is required. Abraham was not sinless. He wasn't spotless. All he was required to do was to believe. And as soon as he believed, it was counted for him for righteousness. Everybody in the scripture that believed were classified as righteous. I don't know how long you have been in sin. I don't know how long you have been in that evil practice. God is still a merciful God. If you show mercy to Rahab, the international prostitute of international reputation, he will show mercy to you. Are you hearing him? If you are killed and you come to him and cry, he will still pardon you. Paul, the apostle, was a terrorist. Several persons in the scriptures, this God of love, this God of mercy, this God of compassion is still available to meet everyone at the point of need. They have met somebody who is sitting down here and said, I have sinned too much. Yes, it is because of you he came to die. He doesn't like sin, but he doesn't hate you. He loves you. For God so loved the world. That world includes both the sinner and the righteous. Just accept him into your life. He shall be well with you.
Yeah.
I am done. peace with God. It's not about coming to say I'm this and this. Just speak to God Almighty. He loves you. He loves you. Despite your mess, He loves you. Despite those things, He still loves you. And He doesn't want you to remain there. It's just you and your God. Anything can happen tonight. Somebody may sleep and not wake up. And you said, I thought I still had time. Don't bother about who is beside you. You can't be serving God like we serve in cherubim and still be poor. True servants of God have never been poor. That's what our hymn says, since the world was made by Him. And the scripture said, I have been young and now I am old. I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Ask the Lord to empower you to live right. As many as are led, not by man, led by the Spirit of God.
live not on our side. Had been